feeling. And I recently decided to start making YouTube videos. Those are my two foster kittens. And I thought it would be fun to have them in this video. The gray one is Kokiri and the Siamese one is Nabi. And they do have adopters. They're actually going to be adopted this week. So I'm finally doing it. I'm starting a YouTube channel, and you can probably tell in my YouTube channel profile that I've had my YouTube since 2012. And I think I did post some random video from my childhood back then, but then I got too embarrassed and took it down. And ever since, for at least like 8 years, I've been wanting to try YouTubing. And just kept putting it off. And then about a year ago, I became really passionate about something, and I started kind of thinking, I guess I could talk about that in YouTube videos. And just like, at least as a starting point. And I thought about that like in May. And so since then, I just kept telling myself, I better do it. And I'm finally here and doing it. It's probably one of the scariest things I will ever do, but there's like this gut instinct that I have that I just like have to try it. I love how there's like a kitten face like right there. Whoa, and like his face kind of lit up for a second. What?
What are you doing?
Hey, Kiri. So really what this channel is inspired by is the work of someone named Dr. John Sarno, and he coined this term in the 90s called tension myositis syndrome, with the acronym TMS. And here is Navi. She, like many cats, has come to see what is going on with the computer and technology. Seems like cats are just very curious about that. And so basically, I have like a ton of strategies to share with combating chronic pain. It's gonna be like kind of hard to pinpoint each strategy that I've been using. I've been using these in mainly the past year, and just from, and the strategies I found from reading books. I did find these, or I what led me to Dr. John Sarno was actually a nerve conduction specialist who is a doctor. And basically I was going to get a nerve conduction study, and I had already had two nerve conduction studies before that. And kind of like in the span of like 8 or so years, I would get one, and then several years would go by and I still felt pain. And I just thought, oh my gosh, maybe something will be found this time. And the first two times there was nothing significant, just the kind of like minor nerve damage or what have you, which they tell you is just like basically the default with being human. So I went this third time a year ago, and thinking, oh, maybe something else will come up, because I just figured the older I get, probably the worse my nerves get. And I was while I was in the doctor's room and getting like the test set up and just talking to the doctor, he really encouraged me to read the works of this doctor, John Sarno. And he just seemed like really excited about this person. And so from there, I was just very focused on how to kind of implement Dr. Sarno's methods. And I remember pretty soon after that, I was going on this snowboarding trip. I was driving to Lake Tahoe in California, if anyone like wonders where that is. I was driving there by myself, and I had rented a car because the car that I have is not built for the snow. And I just remember like listening to, I think, the other audiobook by John Sarno, Healing Back Pain. And he said something about just like thinking about where the pain was, and just like kind of coupling it with thinking about what stresses was I feeling that day, or just like lately, what kind of stresses just felt really heavy. And I just remember just that simple action of like acknowledging in my head, oh wow, like that has really been stressing me out. Like just that simple action and believing that it could like cause the pain in my body, it made the pain like start dissipating like right there in the moment. And this has been like pain that I've been having for like so many years. And so another thing that I wanted to talk about in the first video is basically what I have going on over here. I do have like some crystals and a salt lamp over here. I'm just going to introduce you to some of them. So this one is an amethyst, obviously. I mean, a lot of people, like this is one of the most popular crystals. And it was pretty expensive, but I just was really drawn towards these kind of like bigger crystal points, and I just really wanted a piece that had like multiple like together. So there's that. Next one I will show is called Angel Aura, which has gotten really popular. I love when they hit around the ping pong ball. It has like, it just sounds like really relaxing for some reason. I think it's just relaxing to hear them like running around and like doing stuff. So Angel Aura. I know that angel aura is basically supposed to like remind us to have fun, and it just has a fun energy. And it doesn't only come in pink. I mean, I think a lot of, like, if you know crystals, you probably know this, but angel aura comes in many different colors. Here is selenite, and this one is just like for, it's a really good cleansing of energy crystal and just helps other crystals when they are around it. Well, it looked cool when they did that. Okay. Clear quartz, and I believe it's just like mainly good like to help with communication, with clear communication, because it's clear. And I just really love, I tend to really love like the more clear ones that just, they look like they're just like they can quench your thirst or something. And it has really cool things going on inside. What are you doing, Abby? What are you doing? She's coming to say hi.
Yes.
Okay. Here is shungite. And this helps with technology and kind of like making sure like electromagnetic waves are kind of like, it like defends us against those. So I do love this one. Actually, like I had a piece of shungite on my old phone case and I would have kept it, but then I got a new phone. Another one that I definitely can't forget to show is this huge chunk of tourmaline. It is just like the best thing ever. Tourmaline was like the first thing that, probably like the one piece of jewelry that I like have loved the most in my life, because I'm not a big jewelry person. Don't have it. I never really have earrings on. Sometimes I go through random phases where I wear earrings, but also tourmaline, it kind of breaks off easily, like some already broke off, but that's okay. Tourmaline is for protection, and it is just a wonderful crystal. Also, it is grounding, protecting and grounding. This is lava rock, and it's kind of, it's very new to my collection, and it's really fun because I learned that you can put essential oils on it and it will diffuse it naturally. Who doesn't? Hi, so I just want to conclude my video with the kittens playing with their cat toys, and also this will give me a chance to kind of wrap up my video. I wanted to clarify that in my description, I'm going to have some links to the books that I mentioned, as well as another book that is kind of a branch off of Dr. Sarno's work. And just to let you know, they are affiliate links, so I could possibly get a profit if one of you would like to purchase a book. And I'm also going to include a couple other things I recommend
for kind of work related to the what Dr. Sarno really recommends, which is along the lines of just holistic living and really steering away from the pharmaceutical industry. And so also I want to put in a quick disclaimer that I am not a doctor, and I'm basing all of my statements off of Dr. John Sarno's work and my experiences with kind of implementing his recommended methods. And lastly, I just want to thank you so much for watching my video, and feel free to leave any question or comment or whatever feedback you may have for me, and just anything that you would be interested in getting to know further about what I talked about. So thank you again for watching, and I will see you in my next video.